we gonna do right here is go back. Way back. Back into time.
It's time to kick it old school with a new school flair. Taking you back to a time where things felt good.
Wow, I feel good.
Welcome to Old Fashioned Health. Today is the day to take back your health. Old Fashioned Health is just the right place to do it. Your host, Alvin, is determined to make sure you are in good health inside and out. Now, the time has come for some good Old Fashioned Health right here on 1100 AM. Here's
Alvin!
Okay!
What's up, what's up, what's up? How y'all doing? How y'all doing? This is Alvin and DJ 9D on the real 1100. What's up, DJ?
Man, what's going on, brother Alvin? What's going on, Atlanta?
Well, you always take this plane all smooth, I tell you.
Man, I try to. I try
like
to.
You know what
saying?
I would do with myself.
But it's been a long time, brother. I feel like, you know, I missed you last Friday. Missed you last Friday.
Yeah,
but
it was time. I was up in the mountains, and when I tell you, it was amazing.
Yeah.
I was in the mountains with my family. We had a cabin trip, and it was...
That's what's up, man.
I got no sleep. None. But it was absolutely amazing.
That's what's up, brother.
But come back. I'm all excited and refreshed and revitalized and all that kind of thing. And you know what we do here on Old Fashioned Health. We talk about healthy information, products, and or services.
Yes, sir.
So, I found this guy.
Who this
Instagram,
guy is?
Instagram, man. Y'all see, y'all be on me about eating healthy and talking stuff. But I got Mr. Shakiem in the house with us today. In case I'm pronouncing the name right, I'm going to make sure he pronounces it. But I discovered this brother on Instagram.
Mm-hmm.
And so he started telling us, here's what happened, man. He makes these videos, and a lot of times he talk about foods, different foods you can eat, how to get rid of high blood pressure, high cholesterol, testosterone levels, and all those kind of things that mm-hmm. we talk about.
Yeah.
But he does his research, because I follow, every time you usually tell a story, I kind of go look it up and see, it's like, okay, yeah, or I talk about the same thing. So, you know, it's like-minded doing the same thing.
Right.
So I wanted you all to have, I wanted to have him on the show, because he's the master of talking, because all of his videos are specifically talking about healthy eating and the things you need to do to get your blood pressure low, your cholesterol low, your testosterone level right, your skin, your hair, all that kind of stuff.
I feel like this is well needed, man, especially in our community when it comes to just eating, you know. It's high.
I know,
it's
right?
It's real high.
And, you know, we had went through this thing about eating. So I don't eat pork or beef, and I stopped eating chicken, like, 2 years. It's been 2 years now.
It's been a year.
Man, it seemed like time.
It feels like two.
But it's been about a year now since I stopped eating chicken. But we had this habit of, man, 10-piece after the show with some fries. Air fried.
But nah, man, I like to mention I changed my way of eating, man. I'm on like a whole week now, my first week. You know,
how'd you do?
It feels good. I'm not going to lie. It feels good. You don't feel heavy. You wake up, your stomach not
That's
all tossing
right.
and turning.
Right.
It feels good.
So, I want to introduce Shakiem, and then when we get back, we're going to show Shakiem how we make this show rock. So,
okay,
ladies and gentlemen, we have Mr. Shakiem in the house with us, man.
Please
pronounce
your
name properly and tell them a little bit about yourself and all the great things you're doing.
Yes, sir.
All right, man. My name is Shakiem Alar Jameen. That's my actual name.
Mm-hmm.
Born Instagram, my name is Shalar89.
Okay.
And I call myself the facilitator because I'm facilitating information to the people.
Okay.
You know, things concerning health, nutrition, mental development, you know, dealing with the laws of the universe.
Okay.
So that's kind of where I'm at with it.
Yeah, we need all that.
Yeah,
we need all that now. So don't hold back on nothing. Give us all the good stuff. And we might have to invite you here 1, 2, 3 more times to get it all out.
Oh, yeah.
You know
I live in the area, so.
Okay. Yeah.
So you mean to tell me you came here with $1 million worth of games and you giving us for free?
Definitely.
Okay.
Definitely.
Man, it may be a receipt at the end of the day. We just need to check.
But yeah, but that's my thing, sharing information, you know
right.
what I'm saying?
Word.
That'll help people. Because my father taught me, he said knowledge is free.
Oh, yeah.
Wow.
You know, so I'm giving it out for free.
We appreciate that, man.
Yeah,
we appreciate that.
Definitely.
So, we're going to have Mr. Shakiem here with us the whole hour.
Mm-hmm.
And be talking about everything related to health. And I'm so excited he's here.
Yeah.
Please feel free to call in at 404-603-8770 is the number to call for any questions, concerns. He's going to tell you how to get that blood pressure right, how to get that cholesterol right. And I want you to try to explain to them how they can just stop eating chicken all of a sudden, because that's going to be hard.
Oof.
A lot of people going to have a hard time. We're going to talk about that. And a few other things is pertaining to health is what we're going to do now. Now,
okay.
I told you this is the... Old Fashioned Health Show. We do old school music and everything.
Yeah, I love old school.
We're going to see how much you know all your old school music. We're going to see if you know your old school music, because we will be trying.
Okay.
And so we bounce between music and conversation and things like that here on the show. Yeah. All right?
All right.
And one other thing. We always start our show off with the Black National Anthem.
And tell them why, brother.
And we're doing that because we're trying to educate our HBCUs to start playing the Black National Anthem before the games, you know, like they do with the NFL. So, I mean, I went to Jackson State. We never played the Black National Anthem, and I don't understand that. So we always want to take a knee because they National Anthem. We know a little salty about what that means. So since we have our own anthem, why don't you play it at HBCUs?
Right.
So a lot of times people come in the stadium, in the studio, be like, so do you know the Black National Anthem?
I don't know.
Okay, so we're going to play it for you. See if you've never heard it before. But it's a Black National Anthem. It was written by two brothers. Okay. One was a poet and one was a lawyer.
Okay.
And the poet himself, he wrote it, and they put it to music, and then now you have the Black National Anthem. But I'm certain you've heard it before, but when you hear it now, you'll be like, okay, so that's our own anthem. So that's a little bit of something I'm going to give you, all right?
All right, cool.
All right, old school.
Yes, sir.
Are you on the nines, twos, threes? What you on today?
Man, I'm on 100 and thousands.
Okay, well, you do your thing, man. All right, y'all, this is Alvin and DJ 9D on the real 1100.
Classic.
Classics are forever. Being unique and creative is a gift. Represent it well, and respect will be granted. Get your Classics apparel today at classicsbrand.com. Classics isn't just a brand, it's a lifestyle.
Classics.
Attention pet owners. If you're looking for exceptional veterinary care in a friendly and comfortable environment, you should visit Just for Pets Wellness Center. Just for Pets Wellness Center provides preventative medicine and treatment, and also advanced state-of-the-art veterinary dental care and surgery, all while keeping your pet safe and comfortable. For quality care for your pets and peace of mind for yourself, visit just the number 4 pets, FL.vet, to make an appointment today.
All right, y'all. Welcome back to the Old Fashioned Health Show. Good health inside and out. DJ 9D, what's going on, man?
Man, what's going on, brother? What's going on, Atlanta? It feels good to be back on this beautiful Thursday, man.
I know,
man.
Right, man? Listen, I just talked to our young man, the brother here. I'm being called. It's going. So listen, let me tell you, you're going to get the name right.
I had
to get two or three things. Shakiem.
You
know, I don't want to mess it up, but we have Shakiem in the house. I want y'all to please call in 404-603-8770 is the number to call. We're talking about all things health here, and we're covering a lot of health information. We bounce between music and everything.
Word.
So we already got him on the first song. He had never heard of Black National Anthem. He's like, man, it sounds really good.
Record,
it sounds like church,
beautiful,
man.
Record. Yeah,
so but the missus knew exactly what it was.
Oh,
ain't that
really?
Kind of like us? We don't know that the missus know. Yeah, she said, we sang this in school. He's like, no, we didn't do that in New York.
We didn't do that.
We did other stuff, but not that.
Boring version.
Yeah, they didn't do that. Man, I really appreciate you coming so much, man. So let's start out with the first thing. The last post I saw you talking about was high blood pressure.
Right. Mm-hmm.
What are the foods or the things that you told people they could do on your Instagram account that would help them with their blood pressure problem?
Okay. Blood pressure is caused by plaque buildup in the body.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? And plaque is just dry mucus,
mm-hmm.
which is white blood cells and fat deposits.
Okay.
So what happens is it start to block the flow of blood,
mm-hmm.
and you know the blood has to push through, so it causes the blood pressure to be high.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So what I was telling people was to cleanse your arteries, black seed oil. Black seed oil will cleanse your arteries.
Okay.
You know, garlic will cleanse your arteries.
Okay.
Ginger will cleanse your arteries.
Okay.
Yeah. So if you like, what I do is before I go to sleep, I take a clove of garlic, I cut up into 6 pieces, and I swallow like pills. And what that does is it helps your stomach. You know what I'm saying? It helps you digest and break down, you know, all the stuff that's in there, and it just pushes it straight on through.
Man, I'll be having bad dreams at night of everything I think about. but the garlic actually helps cleanse your digestive system.
Yes,
up.
Yes.
So,
and it's strong. Like, you don't want to chew it up. You want to swallow it.
Okay.
So if you chew it, it'll burn you up.
Yes. The miss is shaking her head like, no, don't do it.
Yeah.
She's like, don't do it.
Yeah.
So how long have you been doing this?
Right.
I started 4/22.
Okay.
That was the day I did my cleanse. Like, the cleanse I did prior to that, I did 3 Granny Smith apples, make sure they're organic.
Mm.
I did a piece of ginger, you know, like a nice little piece, cut it up, shaved it, some lemon juice. And I took some pink Himalayan salt and I dissolved in a little bit of water. Then I poured it into the blender, blended it up, and I drunk it. Now, the blender that I use is called the Vitamix.
I'm familiar with that.
Yeah, it's a 2-horsepower motor.
Okay.
So it really breaks the food down and unlocks all the nutrients.
How did it taste?
Oh, it tasted good.
And then after
it had a little kick from the ginger, but it tasted good.
And after you drank it, then what was the feeling?
The next day around 12 o'clock, I was walking my dog. I had him in a dog park. And I felt it coming, so I ran back home.
and he got your system right.
Yes.
And how did you feel afterwards?
I felt good.
I mean, did you feel lighter? Did you feel like, okay, I can... Do you have to do this? Did you do this more than one time? And then what did you do?
Nah, I just did it for that day.
First cleanse.
That was the first cleanse. And then after that, I ordered an oxygen colon cleanse from the Global Healing Center.
Mm.
So when I did that, I lost 7 pounds during that process.
Okay, so the oxygen.
What is that?
All right, it's called Oxy Powder. What it does is let me give you an example. You know, you put soap scrub on your on the towels in your bathroom, and it start to scrub it off.
Yeah.
These OxyPotter, what you do is you take 4 to 6 pills before you go to sleep.
Uh-huh.
And what it does is it start to, you know, clean all the plaque and all the stuff, all the buildup in your intestinal walls. Mm-hmm. So when you wake up the next day, you'll have 3 to 5 bowel movements.
I'm sure.
Yeah, the first 2 days is crucial. But then the rest of the days, you know, it's kind of smooth.
What do you mean by crucial? You mean don't go to work?
I wasn't at work. I was off those days.
Okay, so
but if you are at work, make sure you're close to a bathroom.
Okay.
You definitely going to feel it. Now, this didn't come with no diet plan, like eat, you know, certain foods.
Right.
So I created 3 smoothies, a green smoothie, an orange smoothie, and a red smoothie.
And what you put on them?
All right, my green smoothie, I put kale in there.
Okay.
I put spinach. I put cilantro. I put celery, 2 Granny Smith apples. What else I put in there? Kiwis.
Mm.
And then my enhancements is sea moss. You know, sea moss is very good. It has 92 of the 102 minerals that the body needs.
Okay.
Wow.
So I put that in there. I put a mixture of hemp seeds, chia seeds, and it's another seed. I can't think of it right
now. Okay. And you put all this in one smoothie, blended it up, and then you drink.
Now, the Vitamix is very important because I don't think a regular blender can break it down,
right,
you know, to where you can drink it smoothly.
Okay.
Right.
Like, if you put in a regular blender, it's going to be all chunky. It probably won't taste right.
Right.
But that Vitamix is crucial to how, you know, how I make my smoothies.
Man, how long you been eating like this?
Right.
What was you eating like? So you was one of them 10-piece lemon pepper guys?
Nah, me and my wife would go out to eat every night. Like, she's a supervisor. She get off work like 5, 6 o'clock. You know, I'm a shift worker. I get off at 10. So she won't eat until we get together. So we'll go to Fridays.
That's what y'all used to do?
Yeah, you go to Fridays, Chili's. You know, all the places that open late at night.
Right.
IHOP. And we were just eating crazy. So I was like, yo, I feel like, you know, sickness is coming upon me.
Right.
Like, I might have a heart attack. You know, I might have diabetes. You know, I might be developing a chronic illness.
Right.
So I said, I need to do something about this.
So when did you make that decision? Did you just start doing this year, the beginning of the year? Or how long have you been doing it?
This year. I started this year.
So you started the new year.
I was always conscious. I always had the knowledge, but I didn't apply it.
Okay.
So now I started applying it, you know, because I'm a little older than that.
So this is August, right? This is August.
Mm.
And you started doing this in January. So already from January to now, how much weight have you lost?
23 pounds.
What?
Yeah, I was 235.8.6.
Right, you can go around it up.
That
was 237.
And I lost 23 pounds in the process. Because at first I did the colon cleanse,
mm-hmm.
and then I did the liver cleanse. During the liver cleanse, I lost 6 pounds.
Yeah. Wow.
And then you can see the actual liver stones in your, you know.
Really?
I took a picture of it.
Wow.
Oh, that's nasty.
I wanted to post the picture, but I don't think people
thank
would
you
have took it. You know.
Yeah, that wouldn't have worked. I probably would not have followed you no more.
But this the thing with the liver stones. When you, for the people that eat meat,
right.
When you eat meat, first of all, you're getting secondhand protein.
Okay.
And all those animals that you're eating,
mm-hmm.
they are vegetarians. Cows are vegetarians.
Yes, they are.
Chickens.
Mm-hmm.
What else? Turkeys.
Mm-hmm.
You know, all these animals are vegetarians. And then a virus. What a virus is DNA and RNA cloaked in protein. So when you're eating this, it starts to replicate in your body. It'll take over your nervous system, and you'll start craving fried chicken, McDonald's, Burger King, and all these other, you know, junk foods and genetically modified foods.
You hear that, Oscar?
Man, I hear it.
Yeah. So we kind of been I've been more on the health kick longer than my co-host.
But he looked good. He looked like he ain't shit.
Oh, he on it now.
I do my little thing or whatever. But I really want to know, like, where do you get all your information? Do you look it up yourself? Did somebody put you up on game?
Well, right. I've been reading and studying since I was 15 years old.
Okay.
So I've been studying for a long time.
But you just decided to really put it to work this year.
Right.
Yeah. Well, my cousin, you know, he's a digital marketer.
Okay.
You know, shout out to my cousin, Elijah Ross.
Okay.
And he said, yo, shout, all this information you putting out, let's do something with it.
Okay.
Let's create an Instagram page.
Word.
And let's do it.
Okay.
And I was like, all right, come on, let's do it. So he would give me different topics to talk about. Like, if you look at my page, first I started talking about the laws.
Right.
Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? And one of the laws I want to speak on today is the law of gender. And that's dealing with feminine and masculine energy.
Okay.
Like electromagnetic energy Like electro is feminine mm-hmm. and magnetic, you know what I'm saying, is masculine. Mm-hmm. And they could be interchangeable. When you put them together, that's electromagnetic energy.
Right.
And that ties into the law of attraction. That's what makes us attractive. You know what I'm saying? The first law is vibration. Everything mm-hmm. vibrates on mm-hmm. different frequencies and tones.
Right.
The secondary law is attraction. And it splits off into two pieces,
right.
expectancy and desire. You know what I'm saying? So whatever you desire, if you're expecting it, it's going to come. Because what you want wants you.
I want $1 million and I'm just hoping it'll stop feeling like it wants me.
You got to expect it.
I do expect it.
Yeah, you got to expect it.
Every day. I expect it every day. Yeah. So the law of attraction of expecting something, you really relate to the fact of what you believe in. Right. And what you expect is what
like
you
this. Get. This is the law of attraction manifesting in my life.
You being here,
me being here, me having my IG page, you know, putting out the videos, even me getting married at the age of 41. I said to myself, by the age 40, I either want to be married or be with the person I'm going to marry.
Mm. Okay.
And here I am. You know what I'm saying? I always desired to be back in shape because I moved down to Atlanta in 2011.
Okay.
I was cut up. My waves were spinning. I had a beehive on my head. But living down here, eating. And laid back, living in the driving everywhere, drive through food, drive through pharmacy, drive through cleaners, you're not getting that activity.
Right. So who you think fault was that?
It was my fault.
You think? So
yeah,
you let yourself go. You let yourself go.
Yeah, I let myself go. So yeah, I take full responsibility for that.
All right.
How often do you go to the gym?
I don't go to the gym at all. I work out in the house.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
But I'm going to get a gym membership. I went to Planet Fitness. Because, see, growing up in New York, if you look at a lot of videos like the bartenders and dudes like that, we go to the parks and get busy.
Right.
We do pull-ups, push-ups, dips. Mm. And I grew up in Far Rockaway, so I'm on the beach.
Okay.
So I would go jogging in the beach. I would jog forwards and jog backwards.
Wow.
And that transformed my body. Like, I was living in Indiana for about 3 years.
Gary.
And I came back. No, I was in Terre Haute, Indiana.
Okay.
Mm. Yeah, slowing backwards.
Okay.
Oh, no disrespect, Terre Haute, Indiana. So I came home. I had a Team Rock sweatsuit.
Okay.
My mother looked at me. She said, "You look like Homer Simpson." So I dropped my bag. Right across the street, it's a workout center. You got the pull-up bar, the dip bar, and the little things to do the push-ups.
Right.
2 months, I was looking like you. I was out there every day getting busy.
You didn't like Homer Simpson look?
Nah.
Nah, man.
I like being chiseled.
I usually tell everybody this, especially when it comes down to just getting in shape.
Uh-huh.
Prison workouts, man. You can't beat it. You can't beat it.
You know what? It's funny you say that. I was talking
to my friends,
right?
Right.
And they said, "Yo, Sha, get a deck of cards."
Right.
Because in jail, they do the deck of cards.
Mm-hmm.
Like, say you flip a card and it's six. Maybe six ain't enough. So you'll flip another card. It's seven. It's 13.
Yeah.
Or you just keep flipping until you feel comfortable with the number. You add those cards up.
Yeah.
And you do the push-ups. So that's what I've been doing for the past 2-3 nights.
All right, so that's why you do yours also?
I do mine like that every night.
Is that a Florida thing?
Nah, man.
That's a universal thing.
That's universal.
I don't know about that.
It makes it easier because usually I'll do like 300 and I used to cut them down to 50s every night.
Okay.
But when I had a whole deck of cards, I'm like, why overwork and you just get that work in? You know, just lay it down and do them.
You missed the push-up challenge. We used to do like 300 push-ups. How many were we doing? 150 push-ups per show.
Yeah.
So we would take a break and do sets of 50. We did that for a while.
Yeah.
And then we kind of cut back. We ain't did it in about 2 months now.
Man, look.
Yes, about 2 months. But when we first started doing it, I think my co-host was like, he's going to be able to do it. But
you know, eating right and exercising go hand in hand.
Yes.
Yeah.
Anybody, I would challenge you. The first thing you want to do is do a colon cleanse
mm-hmm.
because you absorb all your nutrients in your stomach.
Mm-hmm.
So the first thing you want to do is do a colon cleanse.
Okay.
Now, what I do is I drink smoothies.
Okay.
When you liquefy your food, it absorbs to your bloodstream a lot faster.
Yes, yes, it does.
Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? As opposed to chewing.
Right.
Right.
You know?
Yeah. Smoothies is my thing. Yeah. I don't see you ever posting any of your smoothies and stuff.
What I'm doing is I'm working on a PDF. I'm presently putting that together.
Okay.
And I'm gonna put that out for free. You know.
Okay.
Letting people know what's in my smoothies.
Right.
I took pictures of all the fruits and vegetables. You know.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Yeah.
Yeah. So do your inbox stay full? People ask you how do you make this? What do you take for high blood pressure? What do you take for cholesterol?
Right.
And all that kind of thing.
Yeah. A lot of people come to me for help. A lot of people.
Yeah. You should see his Instagram. So this is the thing that makes your Instagram so easy, so interesting. It's like there's no fanfare with it. It's just him sitting there saying, "Listen, basically, you take this, you take that to get rid of your high blood pressure, and give you a little bit of wisdom to go with it, and it's done. So it's like in and out, telling you what you need to do, which is perfect. Yeah, one minute. I mean, it's the end of it. You know me, I'd be trying to give you some music and songs.
But that's good because, you know, being on social media, people are attracted only for a certain amount of time.
Our attention span is short. We live in the world of instant gratification.
It's been like that. Man, listen, ain't nothing new under the sun. You know, here's the thing I believe in is that whatever we're seeing now has happened before.
On a
different level, different slow.
Right.
A slower or something. Like, I remember... I was around some of my aunts and uncles, and they talking about all that cussing they do on the radio and this, that, and that. I said, did y'all remember Millie Jackson, how she used to cuss on the radio when she would sing?
Yeah.
Just the same way. Rick James.
Oh, yeah.
Well, the moral standard in America has dropped. Like, you know, I'm 41. I was born in 1977.
Okay.
I can remember watching the show I Love Lucy.
Right.
And Ricky and Lucy was a married couple.
Now,
when they did bedroom scenes, they was in separate beds.
Always.
Fully pajamas.
Right.
Right.
And when Lucy was pregnant, they would say, you know, the producers said, don't say pregnant because they don't know how the people would react to them saying pregnant.
Right, right.
So they said she was with child, like in
the Bible. Right.
So now, fast forward to today.
You're watching a full birth.
It's like you're watching dry porn.
Right.
You know, it's no, the moral standard has dropped.
Yeah.
Let me tell y'all, so I'm older than you.
Mm-hmm.
I remember when, this is not embarrassing, but.
What, James Cadden?
Me and my buddies, we used to get the Sears catalog and be like, oh, look at that. You know, just look. Because it wasn't, now you just get you something out the grocery store and just flip through. So the thing about it is times have changed.
Yeah.
And I try not to allow the world to generate in my mind how bad it is or how good it is. My good and my bad is what's in my mind.
You know
what I'm saying? Right. Otherwise, you get caught up in the whole world of how fast it's going versus how slow it's going, where it should be versus where it's not, global warming versus why is it too hot, why is it too cold. All I have is today. And I just do what I can for today.
And then
when tomorrow comes, like I'm ready. And like you were saying, whatever you think about is what you kind of create in your mind.
You know, your life is a printout of your subconscious.
Yeah. So I have to really, and then I'm always a little concerned. Are you always concerned about when we read a lot of material about the things that you can and can't do or foods you can and can't eat? Does it ever concern you about how accurate that stuff is? Like, okay, so they talk about eating according to your blood type.
Okay.
I personally got some questions about that. I don't really buy the whole thing.
It don't. Go ahead,
Tim.
All right. I got this book, right? And I recommend everybody get this book. It's called The China Study, right?
I've read The China Study. I know exactly what
you're
talking about.
So in that book, he says, you know, the book about eating right for your type.
Right.
The beach diet, all those books.
Yeah.
All those books are inaccurate. And a lot of people that applied that has died. You know what I'm saying? Based on what the book was teaching. So what he's saying is, plant-based diet. You want to get on a plant-based diet. It don't matter what your blood type is.
Right.
As long as you stick into a plant-based diet, you'll be fine.
So with the China study, from what I've understood when I read the book and talk about the things you should not do, for instance, eating according to your blood type, this is what's interesting to me. There's some countries that they don't have any type of heart disease, period, in the Mediterranean countries. Mm-hmm. Nobody's ever had a heart any type of heart problems at all.
Wow.
At all. No high cholesterol, period. Right? So if eating according to your blood type is actually accurate, everybody in the Mediterranean doesn't have the same blood type, right?
So I'm pretty sure they
do. So how is that an accurate theology if you believe eating according to your blood type is right?
But now blood types do account for certain things.
Right.
Like, for instance, man, the strongest blood type is O negative.
Mm-hmm.
Let's say you go to the hospital and you need blood and they don't know what your blood type is. They're going to give you O negative.
Because it can work with any...
Yeah.
Yeah.
Now, somebody who's O positive, they can only give to all the other positive blood types. But a person of O positive can't take blood from A positive, B positive.
Right.
They can only get from another O positive or O negative.
Right.
So it accounts for something in that regards. But far as like diet and nutrition,
no.
Nah.
I don't believe, and because I don't see how you can go to a Mediterranean country and say these people live a long time. There's no history of any type of heart disease.
Mm-hmm.
But they're eating, you know, all of the dishes that and the things that they eat. But if the blood type has anything to do with it, then why is everybody having the same type of positive health? You know, their health is great. And it's because they have plant-based type of eating.
And you know, their culture is different. And when you think the word coaching just mean a group of people doing the same thing. That's all coach is.
Yeah, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like the coach in New York, we wear Air Force Ones. Yeah. The coach down in Florida, they wear Reeboks. You know
that's
what I'm saying?
Y'all
it's
wear
a group of people doing the same thing.
Yeah. Wear Reeboks.
Yeah, I've been down there.
Y'all wearing Reeboks. Oh, Lord, you still doing the Reebok, huh?
Hey, nah,
I got a pair of Reeboks. I was going with next time I come, I wear.
I ain't gonna lie, they coming back. A lot of stuff coming back, though. A lot of stuff.
Yeah, I'm old school. Man, I got some All Stars.
I wore some All Stars yesterday. They were so cool.
Wow.
All right, y'all, we're going to take a quick break. This is Alvin, DJ 9D, and Shakiem in the studio with us. Y'all, please feel free to call in at 404-603-8770. Let me ask him to give you all his Instagram while we take this break. We're going to play an old school song.
Yeah, you can find me on Instagram at Shalal89, S-H-A-L-L-A-H-8-9. That's Shalal89.
All right. When we come back, y'all, we got a lot more to talk about this whole health thing, all right? This is The Real 1100.
I'm not afraid to Classics
are forever. Being unique and creative is a gift. Represent it well, and respect will be granted. Get your Classics apparel today at ClassicsBrand.com. Classics isn't just a brand, it's a lifestyle.
Classics.
Pull up to Urban City Market, your alternative neighborhood bodega. An upscale organic convenience store located in Midtown Atlanta, stop by for weekly events that showcase the best healthy food Atlanta has to offer. Check out the Urban City Market online or in person at 1016 Howell Mill Road in Midtown Atlanta. So pull up to Urban City Market, your alternative neighborhood bodega.
All right, y'all. Welcome back to the Old Fashioned Health Show. Good health inside and out here with DJ 9D and Salute. I'm going to Al. You know what? You got to pronounce that
name. Shakiem.
Yeah, that's all right. I do say it a few times. Yeah,
few times, more shows, we'll get it right. Right. There's a couple of food items that I want to talk about to get your opinion on. Okay. For instance, what do you think about fruits that are grown and there's no seeds? Like, for instance, they always talk about
Feelers grapes.
So I went to a grocery store the other day, and they had this big old thing of genetic. They had organic grapes, right?
Right.
But I'm trying to figure out, how is this organic, and I don't see no seeds in these grapes.
Right.
Tell me what your opinion is.
I think, for one, I think they commercialized the word organic.
Yeah. Of course, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? To get people to buy it.
Okay.
Because, you know, America is about mass production.
Yes.
You know, people don't focus on what they need. They focus on their desires.
Mm. Right.
Mm. But to answer your question, anything without seed can't reproduce.
That's right.
That's why everything has seeds to reproduce and keep going. If you take the seed out of a woman, how's she going to make children?
Right. Mm.
You know what I'm saying? Right. So I would recommend people stay away from seedless. You know,
okay.
Like I said, anything without seed can't reproduce. It has been genetically modified. Another word is bioengineered.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? So, because this is the thing. Whatever you eat, they said whatever you eat, you become.
Yes.
Because your cells reproduce every 35 days off of the food that you eat. So this health and wellness journey, it's a process. It's an ongoing process. It ain't a one-time thing.
Right.
You got to keep doing it. And over a period of time, you'll see some immediate changes.
Mm-hmm.
But over a period of time of doing it, you'll be the last one to notice the changes.
You know? Mm.
Yeah.
So you talked about you've been doing this whole health regimen since January. We can give it to January. Is that right?
Mm-hmm.
That's correct. Okay.
That's cool. Yeah.
So, but prior to that, you wasn't always eating healthy.
Nah, I wouldn't eat no pork. Like, I would have my spurts.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? Like, when I was living alone, I would make my salads. It'd be kale, spinach, cilantro, red, yellow, and orange peppers, black olives. You know, I always ate right. I always try to keep a balance between eating right. And, you know, I don't eat pork. You know what I'm saying? I don't eat pork because, you know, my father's Islamic.
He's
part of the 5% Nation of Islam. And my mom, she Caribbean.
Okay.
So we'll have our meat, like we eat red snappers, curry goat, curry chicken, and we'll have the right rice. But we always had a salad.
Okay.
So it's always been a balance.
Okay.
I always wonder, like, you know, when it comes down to just eating, you know, straight vegetables and fruits and all that stuff, would you say it's okay to eat certain types of fish?
Mm.
Like, what fish do you recommend?
What I eat sometimes is wild caught salmon.
Mm. Okay.
Sockeye?
Yeah.
Mm.
But make sure it's wild. But see, you really can't tell because, see, this was going on, man. They're throwing this thing in the ocean called core exit.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, what they're throwing in the ocean is getting inside the fish.
Right.
And then the mercury that's in the ocean. You know, because there's things going on in the ocean. Like, for instance, I watched this video the other day. You know those satellites they got out in space?
Mm.
There's a part of the ocean. It's like an abyss. They drop those, or they guide those satellites to go down there, and they're made of metal. And you add, you know, water and metal, it start to release, you know, toxins.
I even remember the oil leak we had back in what?
They 08? Was cleaning up with core exit. That's how they would clean it up.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah. Yep. So you got all these, and then 80% of the air we breathe is coming from algae from the ocean.
Yeah.
So if you destroy marine life, you're going to destroy life on the planet.
Yeah.
So what do you think about global warming? You think it's real?
It's real. And what I would say to that is methane gas is what's destroying the ozone layer.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? And two-thirds of the methane gas or the methane is caused by them keeping all these animals. I ain't even going to say farm. They keep them in prison.
Okay. Yeah.
Because people desire the flesh of animals. Mm. You know what I'm saying? So this is what's going on. So if everybody was to switch their diet to a plant-based diet, by default, that industry will fall apart because they're not making no money off these animals. They got to let them go.
So they coming up with this thing, Beyond Meat, seems to be a hot item right
now.
Yeah,
it's good.
And you
it's
had
good.
It.
Yeah.
It's good.
Yep.
So how long y'all think that's going to be able to sustain before they have to start adding some byproducts in it to make it last?
Well, what I would say to this, man, my wife rarely cooks.
Okay.
If I'm not blending my food, I'm eating the natural. Like, I made a big salad, and that's what I eat. So we rarely on the stove. So what I would say is stick to nature as close as possible. Like, people in other cultures that live to be 120, 130 years, they more in tune with nature.
Yeah.
Like, what I've been doing for the past 12 days, people know it as earthing or grounding. Mm. But those in the conscious community, they call it screwing in. Mm. Because we are bioelectrical energy sources. And the earth has an energy source, right?
Mm-hmm.
On the surface of the earth, you have electrons, mm-hmm. negatively charged electrons, right?
Okay.
So when you stand on the earth barefooted, whether you're standing on grass, dirt, by a tree, if you live by the beach, the sand, or you in the ocean, these negative electrons, they enter the soles of your feet, and they just travel through your body. And that's what take care of inflammation. One of the causes of inflammation is not being connected to the earth. All the animals are connected to the earth.
Right.
The bugs, you know what I'm saying, the trees. Mm. When you stand by a tree, you get more of that energy because the tree roots, they go miles deep into the dirt.
Right.
You know what I'm saying, looking for nutrients and water. So.
Well, we learn some stuff.
So, yeah, stay, get close to the earth, man. The earth loves you and the earth needs you. Like at 12 noon, that's when the sun is at its highest.
Yes.
Yeah.
Like when you called me, that's what I was doing. I was screwing in. And I had took my slippers off and put them off to the side with my cell phone.
Mm.
And I had my feet in the dirt and I would tilt my head back and just have my hands and just receiving that solar energy.
Right.
That's what vitamin D is solar energy. Mm. So I'm receiving that. And then you got those, the electrons on the earth. It's just taking care of the inflammation, the free radicals, and all that. And I did it for about, how long was out there? For about 30, 40 minutes?
45.
Yeah, so the recommendation for grounding is 30 to 40 minutes, 2 to 3 times a day, depending on your situation. So if you got, like, chronic inflammation, start grounding 2-3 times a day. It don't matter what time. The recommendation is in the morning at 12 noon and 9 o'clock at night. You know what I'm saying? To take care of that. If you got chronic pain, it'll help with that. If you having issues with sleeping, you know what I'm saying? It's people that, you know, they couldn't sleep.
Right.
They started grounding. Because this is the thing with people who have maybe sleep apnea or insomnia.
Right.
Your pineal gland secretes a hormone called melatonin.
Okay.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
Now, in our body, we have this thing called circadian rhythm or biorhythm.
Okay.
Circadian means approximately a day. People are used to the word, you know, diem for per diem and working at a job.
Right, right, right.
So per day. So our circadian rhythm is set according to the sun.
Right.
So when the sun is up, it stops producing melatonin. So you get your energy to get up move around and do what you do during the day.
Right.
So at night when the sun going down, that tells the, when the sun go down, that light or the darkness hit the optic nerve. And it says, okay, start releasing melatonin because it's time to wind down and go to sleep.
Mm.
So when your circadian rhythm is thrown off, because most of us are shift workers, we work inside a building.
Mm.
And
right.
We're getting artificial light from the lights.
Fluorescent lights.
And even our cell phones emit blue light. So you're manipulating your consciousness with that. You know what I'm saying?
Wow.
Like people are on their cell phones all day and they can't sleep because you're manipulating your pineal gland through your optic nerve.
Mm.
So that's why people can't sleep. Yeah. So if you want to reset your circadian rhythm, go outside and get some sun. You know what I'm saying? Maybe 3 to 7 days and it will reset. Like even people that travel, you know what I'm saying? Like I traveled to, I went to California and it's a 3-hour difference between New York and Cali.
Mm.
And I woke up before everybody, it was still dark outside. I seen mountains and stuff. I was like, yo, what time is it?
Right.
So it took me, a few days to adjust to Cali.
Wow. Yeah. That's kind of like when I was, for some strange reason, when I was in the mountains, I had a whole bunch of energy. Mm-hmm. I don't know if because I was around a lot of greenery and stuff.
Right.
Yeah.
But I was like on
all that oxygen
10.
And everything yeah. in there too.
And we was in the high elevation. I was yeah. on top of the trees. It was like
wow.
an energy like
amazing, right?
Man, oh yeah. my God.
Because you know trees or the vegetation, they give off oxygen. Yeah. That's their waste.
Right.
And we breathe out carbon dioxide. Which they feed off of that.
Yep.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Wow.
So, like people who have plants, they tell you talk to your plants.
Yep.
Not so much they hear what you're saying, but it's the carbon dioxide you're giving off.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay. It's not just to be talking to.
Yeah.
I got you.
You breathe out carbon dioxide, and they take in that substance, use it, and then they give off oxygen. So that's our harmonious connection with the earth and everything on the earth.
And it just kills me the fact that we trying to get a dollar and knocking down football fields of it.
Yeah.
You know, it's sad, man.
All about the mighty dollar.
All about the mighty.
So we're going to take another break. He did know the song that came on a minute ago. Yeah, he said it's a long song. So that means he'd been in the club dancing on that song for a long time.
I got
a
mean two-step.
Right, two-step for a long time.
I'm going to break it up a little notch.
We're going to take a break and we'll come back. I want to talk to you about water, alkaline water, and the benefits thereof of water and all that kind of thing. All right? All right, y'all. We'll be right back. Hey, DJ 9D, he giving us the year, knew who it was and everything.
This guy.
Yeah, man.
All right,
that was a hot summer right there.
Man, I sure am so excited about you coming here. I really appreciate it. Before we get too close to the end of the show, give them again your Instagram, how they can reach you,
Yeah, you can check me out on Instagram, Shalal89. S-H-A-L-L-A-H-8-9.
Okay. Shalal89. Yeah, follow me. It's a really good, amazing, Instagram account that shares a lot of information for free.
Word.
You know, eating healthy don't cost you nothing but time for you to try to do it.
Yeah.
I was going to ask you about this whole thing with water crave. Everybody talk about alkaline water. If you notice, I have water, but I got limes in it because
it turns
into alkaline.
Right.
And so I want to know what's your thoughts on water. How do you feel about the benefits of being hydrated?
Okay, yeah, you have to properly hydrate yourself. You know what I'm saying? Like I'm 212 pounds,
mm-hmm.
so I got to drink at least 10 glasses, 8 ounce glasses of water a day.
Mm.
So, you know, when I'm working, I try to drink a glass every hour on the hour.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? That's almost a gallon. You know, a gallon of water is 128 ounces.
Right.
So I try to drink most of it.
Okay.
Yeah. So, you know, you want to properly hydrate yourself. Now, the waters I do drink,
mm-hmm.
I drink distilled water.
Okay.
That's a good one. Mountain spring water.
Mm-hmm.
The reason why I say mountain spring water, because the mountain is a big rock.
Right.
And
right.
when the water, you know,
it
pulls the nutrients, right. it pulls the minerals
right.
off of the rocks, and
right.
you drink it.
And purifies it.
Right.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Now, alkaline water is good. Now, this is what I want to share with people.
Mm.
Your body's supposed to be at 7.365 alkaline.
Okay.
Now, if you can't remember that, you got 7 chakras in your body, and it's 365 days in a year.
Okay.
So 7.365 alkaline.
Okay.
Anything below that, you acidic. And you open yourself up for disease, sickness, and viruses.
Mm-hmm.
7 alkaline and higher, you good. But you don't want to go. You don't want to over alkaline yourself,
right?
Because
right.
you need an acidic environment in certain parts of your body,
right?
Like in your stomach, you got acid,
right?
You
right.
know what I'm saying? You need that to break down food.
Right.
Now, women, their vaginal area or their vaginal canal, it has to be between 3.5 or 4.5 acidic.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? Anything outside of that, you get yeast infections and so on and so forth.
Right.
Mm.
Yeah, so what I would recommend for people to get is, it's called the Kangen
water, uh-huh.
Yeah, yeah, that gives you 11.5 alkaline.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? That's the best one. Like the health food store that I go to,
uh-huh.
they got 10 alkaline.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? That's good, but the best one is 11.5.
Right.
Yeah, we've been drinking this alkaline water for a long time.
Yeah.
We've been talking about the alkaline
and
water.
And see, the beauty of alkaline water is that it fuses with the fat.
Exactly.
Right.
And it helps it come out, you know what I'm saying? It'll help you with eczema. I mean, it's good for internal and external uses.
Right.
And Kessa doesn't grow in alkaline, does it?
No disease can survive in an alkaline environment.
Okay, right. Cool.
Yeah.
I try to tell people whenever you go to the doctor and they start telling you you're a borderline diabetic, a borderline high blood pressure,
mm-hmm.
I would urge you, first of all, to increase your water intake.
Right.
Because a lot of times you have high blood pressure in these things because you're dehydrated.
Mm, right.
And that causes you to have, if your body is 73% water and you don't have everything you need, then the car is going to break down.
Right.
So that's when they start telling you, well, you're borderline diabetic or you're... AST levels are kind of low. Your kidney function, if you start drinking more water and let the body do what it needs to do for flush properly,
mm-hmm.
then you won't have those. That's, you know, it's been my experience.
Yeah, yeah. Also, I want to share, I also shared it in my video. When you have too much sodium in your body,
uh-huh.
you know what I'm saying? Your kidneys can't get rid of that water. It's like stuck in your body because you got too much sodium.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? That'll cause high blood pressure. Also, low liver function will cause high blood pressure. Okay. Now, the liver is the body's doctor. You know what I'm saying? It filters all the toxins out of the food.
Right.
And behind the liver is your gallbladder. It releases bile
right.
to help with digestion. You know what I'm saying? So people who eat meat, what happens is meat create an acidic environment in your body. And in order to offset that acidic environment, your body start pulling calcium from your bones. So the calcium that's not used is deposited into your liver. And that's the cause of liver stones. That's like calcium deposits.
Man,
so when you do a liver cleanse, it helps your body to release those calcium deposits or those liver stones. It softens it up so it can pass through.
Listen, I want you to come back again.
Definitely, man.
I really
Definitely.
Appreciate you being on the show. This is Alvin and DJ 9D. What's the long? Is that right?
Huh? Shakiem. The Lord, Jameen. Yeah, Shakiem. Don't worry about it. We're going to get it right.
We got Mr.
And Shalal89 is my Instagram.
That's what
man.
I was trying to I was yeah. trying to remember the Instagram.
That's all right. That's
right. What we need to just sit in the room and just talk about this thing. Because
I know,
yo,
right? It's been good.
Yeah.
I really appreciate you.
I swear you are.
Thank you. Thank you. Yeah. I appreciate it. Yeah.
See y'all tomorrow.
Peace.
Out. Right. A place in their hearts. 'Cause Jesus is God. He won't let you down.
Thanks for stopping by Old Fashioned Health. With your host, Alvin, we hope this show has been informative and entertaining, and more importantly, hope that we led you in the right direction to have good health inside and out. For more information on Old Fashioned Health, please visit our website at oldfashionedhealth.com. And be sure to join Alvin Monday through Friday from 4 to 5 p.m. for Old Fashioned Health right here on 1100 a.m. Take care.